World Trade Center 1, and it's not was. I am here, and I'm stuck right now.
Now, are you above, Jim, or below?
I have no idea. I have no idea where the plane hit. It's my understanding that it's a plane.
Jim, there are two planes. One went into one tower, one went into the other tower.
Terrorism has rocked the world, impacting on our everyday lives. The media is sometimes questioned in its motives. Some argue it informs the population, while others say it glorifies the terrorist attacks. While all eyes were on the World Trade Center and the aftermath, many have neglected the impact terrorism has had on today's youth and the effect it will have on their future.
Terrorism is wrong. I think freedom of speech compromises the way people talk about terrorism. And I think people hide behind terrorism, behind freedom of speech.
I think if there wasn't the media attention to it, then terrorism would be a smaller object that we had to deal with.
Obviously, religion is a massive thing behind it, but I think it's not. I don't think it's good to say there's one definite thing that causes it.
I think inevitably the world's. We don't get along. Every country has different morals and different values. And until we establish a kind of moral grounding for every country that's the same across all planes, then no one's ever going to get along because they all believe different things.
There's a point where you've gone far enough, and I think they've taken it too far.
I think the extremists, they know they're nutters. They know they're causing a lot of harm. But I think the freedom fighters, they're more delusional. They actually think that they're doing good. Spearheaded guy, I would listen
to what you have to say. They have the right to voice their opinions, but perhaps burning the copy was a bit of an overreaction.
With the signs that they were holding at the time, I mean, a lot of people, I've heard people say it's a cry for help, but when they're holding like signs where they're saying the British soldiers were burning in hell, I think that's not really a cry for help, but really more just starting trouble.
My boyfriend's just joined the army. So it is a really, really tough subject for me because obviously I care about him. I don't want him going there. I also don't want him supporting this country because I don't think this country's worth it. But for everyone who is out there, I do feel for and respect.
No one should have started a war in the first place. I think it was just a big misunderstanding that was taken way too far. And that it could stop at any time.
We shouldn't be there. We shouldn't have been there. In my opinion, we were brought there by America, and all the Americans wanted the oil. And now we're stuck fighting a war which we shouldn't be in.
It's made everyday people in England and other countries less accommodating of people from foreign countries.
It's bad enough as it is, but the media makes it seem worse.
When I'm in like London or something, if I'm on the tube, someone's got a backpack on, I'll be thinking, hang on a minute.
I do get way off
pain,
so I'm going to
makes me panic a little bit. The bombs go at East Midlands Airport. Well, it's quite close to home, and I guess it does make me a little frightened.
I'll still always travel, I mean, on a plane and stuff, but it does make you think now how clever the, like I say, the terrorists are getting. You don't know a thing about the youth of today.
State in your opinion. On September the 11th, 2001, at 8:46 a.m, the first plane hit one of the Twin Towers, changing our world forever. Approximately 3,000 lost their lives, including 19 hijackers involved in the calculated attack by Al-Qaeda toward the US. More than 6,000 were injured, and many were unrecovered from the wreck that was once the World Trade Center. Where were you when they hit?
I was in school at the time. All of our systems went down, and we didn't know what was going off. And then the head teacher came into every class and let us know. And those who had family over there got to leave.
I didn't really understand then, so I didn't really know what was happening. Obviously I knew it was like terrible, but I didn't really understand the whole kind of politics behind it.
To be honest with you, I didn't really understand what was going on. All I remember was my mum kind of stood devastated, and I was like, what's the big deal? It's like a little kid not having a clue what was happening.
I think I was at school, and I remember it being very confusing. I didn't really know what was going on at the time. Because I was quite young and the teachers were quite upset.
I think it probably has had an effect on how people feel about other cultures and how scared they feel when things happen in the press and the news, like 9/11, 7/7 or the foiled bombings. But I think it's important to remember that every generation will face fears about terrorism, whether it be the IRA or, you know, it may have been kind of Nazis in the Second World War. So there's always going to be a threat from terrorism. It's never going to go away. It just mutates and changes for each generation.
Since sort of 9/11, I suppose the youth of today has grown up with much more of an idea of terrorism and the threat of terrorism, war on terror, and it's become part of our sort of everyday parlance, part of our everyday experience, especially within, you know, the media. And I think that a generation of people growing up with that as a background certainly will have affected today's youth.
I think it's made a more complex society for people to live in. I think it's made a more fearful society. I think if you're living in areas such as London, where there are checks on the way in and ways of checks on the way out of the capital, if you're driving cars, even on the subways, I think it's made for a more fearful culture.
7/7 made it very real for us, and it was very close. But you can't predict when these things are going to happen.
I'm not afraid to travel because I have faith that we have enough things in place now to protect me whilst I travel.
All sorts of bad things happen in the world. You can't be sort of afraid to step outside your front door, or else it's, you know, it's no sort of life.